हेलो डियर पार्टिसिपेंट, दिस इज एस कुलकर्णी। वेलकम यू टू दिस प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन कंप्यूटर्स। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वील सी द पार्ट टू लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ टूडेज प्रेजेंटेशन। आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द प्रेजेंटेशन यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंप्यूटर फॉर अ रिट्रायवल ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, मॉनिटरिंग ऑफ ड्रग to inpatients and purchase and inventory control. Roadmap of today's presentation. First, we will see the information retrieval by computer. Then we will go for computers in monitoring a drug to inpatients. And at last, we will see computers in purchase and inventory control. So in this slide, we will see the information retrieval by the computer, that is the relevance of computer in information retrieval. So computer have become an important necessity for pharmacist, because pharmacist who engaged in a DIS, that is drug information services, also in patient counseling, etc., or so on. So here the pharmacist is to satisfy the queries related with the medicines or diseases, disorders, and new innovative therapies. So here the computer will help to pharmacist to get all types of information related to the diseases as well as the medicines, disorder, and the new innovative therapy, because pharmacist is a member of PTC. Also, pharmacist is an head of department of DIC, that is Drug Information Center. So here the computer will help to retrieve the information, that is the authentic information, and collect that information and store in the computer, and that information will be used whenever it is necessary, or this information will be provided to the healthcare team to get the knowledge of that particular point. So it is an important part for the pharmacist. So this information will be easily gathered by utilizing the computer. So here is a National Library of Medicines have launched a computerized information services, that is MedLARS. So the long form of the MedLARS is Medical Literature Analysis Retrieval System. So with the help of this MedLARS, here pharmacist will get the authentic information on the medicines, diseases, disorder, and new therapy which is came at the market. So here the National Library of Medicines help to the users or who want to get the information. So he launched this particular computerized system, that is MedLARS. Also it, that is National Library of Medicines, have launched that particular MedLine as a computerized system through the internet facilities. So MedLine is a medical literature analysis retrieval system online, that is the MedLine. Okay, so these two systems which are launched by the National Library of Medicines, where the authentic information provided to the users. So by using these two systems, here the information you will get on this particular site, on the MedLARS and in the MedLine section. So Here is one software company, that is Micromedex, so which provides a vast number of information on the drug. So with the help of the CDROM technology. So this company which have made this particular type of technique use this particular type of technique to provide the information on the drugs. So the information which is stored in CD or ROM system, that is compact disk or the read-only memory, and the information from the CD or ROM will be retrieved with the help of the computer. Also, here is an ex-pharma, that is the pharma tutor, so which programs CD for pharmacology demo practicals. So in the pharmacy branches, so it will help to give an demo to the students on the pharmacology subject, for the pharmacology subject. So here the pharma tutor which have made that series on the pharmacology demo practicals. So with the help of this CD system, here student will retrieve the information. So here with the help of these softwares or by using the different CD, you can retrieve the information of diseases, medicines, disorders, as well as the new innovative therapies. Let's move to the next here. So you can see in this particular picture. So here the pharmacist will gather in the information with the help of computer system. So this computer which is connected with the internet facility, so any information you will get on the computer if they have connected with the internet facility. So after satisfying the queries related to the medicines, the pharmacist is an happy person. So if the pharmacist will get the information on medicines as well as the diseases, then the pharmacist will be able to guide the other healthcare team, as well as this information will help to the pharmacist in patient counsel. Let's move to the next point. Here we will see the use of computer in monitoring drug to inpatient. So inpatient is an patient or those patient who have admitted in the hospital for the purpose of diagnosis, treatment, and more than that, or any surgery. So here computer is used to monitor drug therapy for hospitalized patient, that is the inpatient. So it can be achieved by the pharmacist using LAN system, that is local area network. So you can see in this picture, so these computers which are connected with LAN system, that is local area network. So pharmacist will get the information of medicine, that is how much stock which is present in the various departments, because all the computers which is present in the hospital which are connected with the LAN system. So here with the help of this system, pharmacist can monitor drug stock of floor stock system and at the patient bedside. So this facility is made available or the depends upon the size and the policies of hospital. In big hospital, you can see this particular LAN system or the drug monitoring system to the inpatient. So it includes the cycle or the monitoring of drug comprises a cycle. So you can see that one. So in that, the first, the field list of drugs which is generated in the computer for ward patient means those patients which have admitted in the wards. So the prescription for that particular patient which is sent in the pharmacy with the help of computer system. So after that, when the pharmacist will get that particular prescription, so pharmacist prepare and label the drug according to the request which is sent by the ward for that particular patient. So here is a responsibility of pharmacist, that is, before the dispensing of medicines to that particular patient, pharmacist must examine the possibility of drug interaction, that is drug-drug interaction or drug-food interaction. If possibility will not be happen, then the pharmacist must send the medicines to the ward. So the drug-drug interaction is one drug which is altered the action of that particular drug in a presence of the another drug. And drug-food interaction means here the action of drug which is altered due to the presence of food. So if such cases or the possibility of such drug interactions, so here pharmacist must communicate with the physician and change the medication. If there is no any possibility, then pharmacist will send the medications to the patient bedside or to the ward section. So after that, here the nurses will have to administer that particular dose. So after administration, the entry should be done in the computer as administration record. When any patient will swallow or administration which is done with that particular dose, so that entry should be done in the computer. So it gives the medication administration record or medicine administration record. So despite this, the diagnosis test drug cost may be entered in the same. So at the time of discharge of patient, so above all these record which is retrieved for the final bill. So this cycle which is happen in case of monitoring of a drug to the inpatient. Let's move to the next. Here in this slide, we'll see the computers in purchase and inventory control. So here, computer will help to maintain the inventory in the hospital as well as in the pharmacy section. Also helps in the purchase the medicines or other material in the hospital or hospital pharmacy. So this is an important task for the hospital authorities to create an absolute program, because so many pharmacy softwares which are available in the market. So with the help of pharmacy softwares, so this purchase and inventory control can be achieved in efficiently. So this particular software helps to track the quantity of medicine available in a drugstore and processes order for it. When the medicine reaches to the reorder point or the order point, when any medicine stock which is coming in the reorder point, so this system or the software will give the information to the pharmacist need to purchase that particular medicine. So this can be done by feeding the different inventory technique in the computer. So let's see that. So here the utilization of perpetual inventory control. Also the setting of various levels, keeping the inventory record, measurement of inventory, and last the finding of moving item. So let's see in detail. So here we will see first, that is utilization of perpetual inventory control. So the computers which is linked with each other, or for the operations such as a receipt, when the any medicines which is received in that particular department. So if we are adding that particular received material or the quantity of that particular medicines in the computer, so it will directly add it to the final stock of that particular medicine, as well as in the issue. If any medicines which is dispensed to that particular patient, so that quantity will be removed from the that particular stock, as well as if any medicine which is returned, so that return quantity will be directly added in that particular stock, and the billing of medicines. So it depends on the price which is put in the computer and some others. So if such operations which is linked to each other, so you will get the correct information or correct inventory of that particular medicines. So you can find, or you can observe, you can examine the stock position of that particular medicines any time. So the position of that particular stock can be updated after every receipt and issue or the return. For example, if any medicines which is received from the supplier, so if these operations which are interlinked or linked to each other, so this quantity which is directly added to the stock. If any issue is done, or you can say any dispensing is done with that medicine, so that quantity will be removed directly from the stock. And if any medicine which is returned in the pharmacy section, and if pharmacist done that particular return quantity in the computer, so that quantity which is directly added in the stock. So if they are linked, so you will get that updated stock position or that medicines at any time. So next, here the setting of various levels. So here the various levels, such as the maximum level of that medicine, minimum level of that particular medicine, as well as the reorder quantity level and the danger stock level. If you are setting these particular levels, so you will get the right or the correct information from the computer. If not, you will not get the correct information. So to maintain the proper inventory for medicines, these levels should be set by the user or by the pharmacist. So you will get the correct information from the computer. So here, after feeding of these levels, it helps in a tracking of optimum inventory. If these levels which are set with the particular medicine, so if these levels which are maintained, so out of stock situation can be prevented. So here the optimum inventory will be maintained. Let's move to the next. Here we'll see the keeping the inventory record. So for accounting purpose or accounting aspect, or the audit inspection and the legal requirement, so at any time you can retrieve the information of the medicines by the use of the computer. So if you are using the computer in the pharmacy, so you will get or you will maintain the all the requirement that is legal, as well as it will help for accounting purpose, also it will help for the audit inspection. So your data which is ready for the legal requirements, or your record can be ready at any time by using the computer. So any information or any data you will get by the use of computer. So next here we will see the measurement of inventory. So here the price of each medicine can be feeded in the computer to measure the value. So at the time of adding the stock of medicines, or after receiving the medicines from the supplier, you must feed that particular quantity with the price in the computer. So here the ABC analysis or ABC technique of inventory can also be regulated by feeding their volume and cost. So ABC is nothing but the always a better control, such as A class, B class category of medicine and C class. So A class contains high cost of the medicine, B class that is medium, the cost is not higher and not be cheaper, and C category contains the low cost medicine. So here the inventory can be maintained by using these categories, that is high cost medicine, medium cost medicine and the low cost medicine. So this can be achieved by feeding their volume as well as the cost of that medicine. So here we'll see the last, that is finding of a moving item. So this can be evaluated by analyzing its utilization or the quantity which is dispensed. So from the stock record in the computer at any framed frequency in N. So you can find the moving item and non-moving item. So it depends on the quantity which is dispensed to the patient, or the drug which is distributed to the patient, or the form. So it helps in assessing demand of any particular item. So those medicines which are, or the quantity of medicine which are dispensed more, so this can be, or the record of that particular moving item can be examined with the help of the computer. So those are sell more, so that is the fast moving items. So those are the medium quantity which is dispensed, so these are the slow moving items, and these those quantity which are dispensed one or two in the month, so that comes under the non moving items. So with the help of the fast moving, slow moving and non moving, so you can get or you can maintain the inventory of that particular medicines. So here this computer will help you to find the moving items. So this is an the computers which are used to maintain the purchase and inventory. If you have any question, you can drop your question on my WhatsApp number or on my email ID. At last, thank you for patient listening. Thank you very much.